how to draw a bar diagram. We discuss the process with an example. Open your textbook. Let's work out 13. Question number 7. Here, the question is, Ramda has a shop selling bag in Hallarpara. Ramda himself makes the bags. I prepare a list of bags sold from the shop this week. At first, we draw two lines. One is horizontal, another vertical. Suppose they intersect at point O. The two lines are perpendicular to each other. We choose the horizontal line. As number of bags sold, and vertical line as number of days. On the horizontal line, one unit of length represents two bags. On the vertical line, each of the 6 days has been taken at equal distance from one another. Twice the length of horizontal rectangles corresponding to each day indicates the number of bags sold in that day. So, we draw rectangles of different length, keeping the width equal. The length of the rectangle depends on how many bags have been sold. Here, 40 bags sold in Monday. 40 bags sold in Monday. See question number 7. So, length of rectangle will be 20 units. So, we draw a rectangle of length 20 units. Here is 20. In each day, 30 bags sold. So, length of rectangle will be 15 units. So, we draw a rectangle of length 15 units. Length of the rectangle is 15 units. Similarly, we see that in Wednesday, 35 bags sold. So, length of rectangle will be 17.5. We identify they are 17.5, so we draw rectangle of length 17.5. In Thursday, we see that 25 bags sold, so length of rectangle will be 12.5. We draw a rectangle of length 12.5. In Friday, 20 bags are sold, so length of rectangle will be 10. So we draw a rectangle of length 10 unit. And Saturday, we see that there are 30 bags sold, so length of rectangle will be 15 units. We draw a rectangle of length 15 units. This is called a bar diagram. This diagram is called a bar diagram. From the diagram, we easily understand that number one, in Monday, maximum number of bags are sold because the length of the rectangle of Monday is longest. Number two, in Friday, least number of bags are sold because the length of the rectangle of the day is smallest. Number three, it is seen from the diagram that the length of rectangle of Tuesday is between the length of Monday and Wednesday. Therefore, the number of bags sold in Tuesday is between that sold in Monday and Wednesday. Again, number four, again we see that total number of bags sold in Monday and Tuesday, is 40 plus 30 equals to 70. In Monday, number of bags sold is 40 as length of rectangle is 20 unit. So number of bags sold 40, and Tuesday length of rectangle is 15 unit. So number of bags sold is 30. So total number 40 plus 30 equals to 70. We see that total number of bags sold in Monday and Tuesday is 40 plus 30.